Well, we're in the neighborhood of Whistler this morning. We have this nice opportunity to see these peaks in the water, and thought we'd stop here and just get a picture of it. Got the smell of balsam poplar in the air. I'm sorry, am I in your way? This is Whistler Mountain. You can see the ski runs. Actually, you can actually see the gondola posts there. Whistler Mountain. See the peaks clearly in the sunrise here. Some of the runs down the side. Whistler Village sprawled at its foot. We're on the road 99 from Whistler up over through some mountains on the way to Lillooet, and then beyond to Banff. And this valley ahead here looks to be filled with fog. It's quite pretty. Amount of timbering through here, and every now and then we get some glimpses of some snow-capped mountains in the distance. It's kind of cool. Duffy Lake along this road 99. Chilly this morning. There's layers of fog around the lake here.
it's not the Grand Canyon of the Yellowstone. This is the Cayuse River Valley, its lower reaches,
in the vicinity, or just upstream from Lillooet.
Apparently, it flows eventually into the Fraser River, which then doubles back down into Vancouver. And into the sounds there. It's still pretty early morning. It's 8:20. And although it's cloudy, the sun hasn't penetrated to the bottom of some of these valleys yet, just from the height of the sun. The Cayuse River on our left is steep, gurgly, flowing, rapidy river. It's got that greenish cast from the glacier flower. Supplies the water to it. Higher up in the valley here, were nice views of glacier cap peaks off to the sides.
Okay. This is a really really pretty spot right here.
Descending here into Lilliput. Lilliput. Cedar Lake.
S-E-T.
Here we are heading toward Cache Creek, away from
Lulua?
No.
Lilliput. Lilliput to Cache Creek. Boy, I don't know what's covered up down there,
not
but
either. Something valuable.
I guess so. It's all just sunshine. Wow, it's a huge area.
There aren't many trees to make shade.
No. That looks like an expensive operation. It's got to be an extremely valuable crop.
Probably potatoes.
Yes. I think so. Ginseng.
Ginseng.
Sign that just said these are ginseng gardens. They're huge. They're, what would you say, Ray? 100 yards wide by a quarter mile long here?
A few acres over here.
Several acres. So we're following the river down there. It's the Fraser River. We're in more or less the upper reaches of it here. And you can follow the Fraser River all the way down, basically, and go off into the Vancouver area, or you can go through the mountains the way that we did, along 99 from Lilliput. You just turn on 99 and follow the Cayuche River, Cayuche Creek. More river-like, really. It's got quite a flow in it, and it's very scenic. And here we're in the sagebrush. You know, 4 hours away, you're into inlets from Puget Sound, and Glacier Cap Mountains are just hardly an hour away from here, right? At least the views of them from the road back to the west. So, we we're hearing about logging some, timber industry. There's plants closing down in Lillooet. Like 60 people were just put out. It's a sawmill, I guess. The veneer plant apparently is still operating, but some things are just too marginal to run.
Lake out there. It's pretty scenic. It's definitely turned into dry country. And this is, of course, a reservoir. The hills around the area are a combination of sagebrush and a few pines and some pretty scrubby grass. Actually, not so much sagebrush here as grass. We have been passing through some sagebrush areas.
Look at the car.
Huh? about 125 today.
Kind of conservative through the mountains here. So the earlier stuff probably wasn't ripple stroke. You can see it out there now.
Driving along the side of Mount Revelstoke National Park, we got all these peaks that stick up around us, and we don't know really how far they are. We don't know if they're the Mount Revelstoke or not, or if possibly it could be the next park over. You know, we've got Glacier National Park, with certainly within viewing distance, and then Banff National Park. But I don't think we'd be seeing some of those. And then there's a lot of peaks and glacial fields outside the parks, so. In any one moment, I'm not too sure.
Is it driving you nuts?
No, Ray is driving me nuts. She's driving me all over.
5,100 miles. That's so far.
So. That guy just pass you like that? Go for it.
Yeah.
Yeah. You back off.
Yeah. I wonder how kind the mountain police are to people from the States going over the speed limit.
I have no idea. Crossing your mind, though, huh?
I've got a lot of speed traps.
You've been seeing them? One, yeah. That's that one.
I mean, two.
I saw. Was it the same guys?
The helicopter
though?
Was a radar.
Well, people have been pretty respectful of the speed limit, haven't they? Now we're in Glacier National Park.
This is the wrong side then, did
you? No. Ray said to him, you better move that, you son of a bitch. We're in Glacier National Park, obviously not a wilderness at this point on the road surface, but nonetheless quite a pretty vista of mountains there that are part of the park. I don't know the names of them. I'm still looking for an entrance station to the park. I don't really seem to focus too much on that right here, although every place you stop says you need to have a permit, including probably this particular spot. See any people up there? Thank you. Exploration Center there, yeah.
We want to go to the summit.
Well,
the way it said, did she say it?
sitting by a rushing mountain stream, and he's drawing the picture of the glacier that he's looking at. Let's see if we can see. Can't quite see his drawing. He's pretty intense at it, huh? That we're in Glacier National Park, not the one in New York, but the one in British Columbia. Trying to see if we can get a peek over to the shoulder. Just like that mountain.